Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'll be reacting to some Brightside riddles. Before we get started, make sure to turn on channel post notifications and subscribe. Now, without further ado, let's get into this.
Alright, sister Vicky gave her this shopping list and asked her to get some groceries. Amy took the list without even looking at it, but when she arrived at the supermarket, she realized that her sister had pranked her. Vicky has encoded the names of the products she needed. Can you help Amy figure out what she's supposed to buy?
Blueberry. Blueberry, yeah. I almost got stuck on that one.
What about this one?
Watermelon.
Watermelon.
I get it. I got it at the last second.
Can you recognize this food?
Kiwi. I mean, that one's just obvious. Yeah, I think we all need that one.
Here's the next Rebus. Can you crack this code?
What?
Great.
That was a good one.
What about this one?
Tack apple?
Pineapple.
Oh.
Next riddle. Any ideas?
What?
Vicky needs some bananas.
Oh. I wouldn't have got that one. That one didn't. Oh, okay.
And here's the final product. Can you figure out what it is?
Lemon.
Lemon.
I was just thinking of the LE at the beginning.
Amy questioned three people standing nearby. Bob, the cashier, said, "Sorry, I didn't see your wallet. I had the other customers." One of the customers, Kim, said, "I think I saw the cleaner take your wallet from the checkout after you left." And the cleaner, Nancy, said, "Who do you think I am? I need this job to support my family." Who stole the wallet?
Well, it looks like she's got something in her hand, but she also is holding something, so I'm guessing her, maybe? There's her.
Kim. She's holding her own wallet in her hand, but there's also Amy's wallet hidden in her boot. Amy didn't want to waste her time, so she told Kim, "I won't call the police if you give me back my wallet and crack my riddle." Kim agreed. Here's the riddle. Can you name 4 days which start with the letter T? Kim's lucky day because she managed to solve this riddle. What was her reply?
Tuesday, Thursday, tomorrow, and today.
Tuesday, Thursday, today, and tomorrow.
Yeah. Oh man,
Amy,
that was
a... Vicky and their boyfriend Josh and Greg went hiking and got lost. They wandered around the forest for a few hours and found this sign. There were three paths.
Okay.
The first one would take them to a toxic swamp. No one has ever returned from
Yeah, I wouldn't do that. Okay. The right, because if it's ice cold, it'd be frozen. Minutes, because 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 7 is 10, and 10 plus 10 is 20. I'm not really sure if I got that, but...
After crossing the river, the guys meet a woodsman. He promises to guide them out of the forest if they solved his riddle.
Alright.
What do an island and the letter G have in common? After the friends answered, the woodsman explained to them how to find the bus stop and disappeared. What did they say?
That one was pretty good. I wouldn't have gotten that. That's why I didn't.
But only one of these vending machines is safe to use. Can you tell which one?
That one has roaches on it, so not that one. And,
someone scribbled cash eater on this vending machine, so it's probably not working. Cockroaches are crawling all over the food inside this machine.
Oh, I thought that was like the name of it. The 7, 8, 9. I mean, you've all heard that one.
Because when it was hungry, 7, 8, 9.
Yeah.
The guys took their seats on the bus. Can you find anything weird here?
Yeah, her legs are like transparent. And so is her whole body. Yeah, I can tell.
Detectives questioned three neighbors. Mary said,
that's a nice house.
Last week, my husband Rick and I were sunbathing in the Maldives. Rick got sunburned, and we had to go back home earlier. We've just come from the airport. Love said, I think I saw a suspicious guy in a hoodie near your house a few hours ago. Joanna said, my boyfriend and I celebrated our anniversary in a restaurant.
Don't you like do an anniversary thing on like in the evening?
Mary, she said that Rick had gotten sunburned, but now he looks perfectly fine, and he doesn't look tanned either.
How are we supposed to know if what his shade of skin was. Okay.
Imagine you have an unlimited number of coins in your wallet. What's the minimum number of coins you'll need to make sure that each of these coins will touch exactly three others?
What?
Can you help Amy get the job?
No. What the heck? Is it unlimited? What is the minimum amount?
The correct answer is four. She should place three coins flat on the table so that they form a triangle and their edges touch each other. Then she can put the fourth coin in the middle on top of the rest. Amy got the job.
That one was smart. I wouldn't have gotten that.
She went home, but on her way home, she realized she'd forgotten her phone in the bank. So she went back and took her phone. Suddenly, the girl heard some weird noise coming from the bank vault. She went there and saw these three men inside the room. She noticed that one of them was an imposter right away. What about you? Can you spot him?
On the right, because his badge should be not on his belt.
The third guy doesn't belong here. Look, he's wearing a police badge. He must be working undercover. The robbers ran away and locked Amy and the police officers inside the vault. Now they have to solve this riddle to unlock the door. They have to find a way to connect these nine stars by using just four lines, all without lifting their hand. Such a task requires creativity, and this shape meets all requirements. But maybe you came up with something better.
I didn't.
Amy bought flowers for her sister's birthday.
Okay.
She was walking down the street, holding the bouquet in her hands. Suddenly, a man in a mask ran up to her, grabbed the flowers, and ran to the nearest restaurant. Amy started crying. A patrol car stopped next to her. Amy told the police officer
sounds good.
What happened. Restaurant together to find the criminal. There were four men with very similar bouquets. Can you tell who robbed Amy?
I want to say it's the guy on the left. Wait, no, the middle, right there.
This guy.
Oh.
Amy's bouquet was tied with purple ribbon. Vicky organized a birthday.
I was wrong.
To avoid uninvited guests, she asked the security guard to set a special password, but her boyfriend Harry, was most definitely not invited, developed a plan that could help him enter the party. He hid near the door and started to listen attentively. When the first guest arrived, the guard said,
"Big guy."
The guest answered with six. Then the second guest arrived, and the guard said six. The guest replied with three. Harry thought he'd heard enough and walked up to the guard. The man said eight, and Harry replied with four. After hearing this answer, the guard asked Harry to leave. Why?
Because he was asking about the number of letters in the word, not the half of it.
Because the password is not half the number, it's the number of letters in the word. He should have said five, because the word eight consists of five letters.
Yeah.
Can you count the number of squares in this image?
Well, obviously these around the little ones don't count. What? I wouldn't have gotten that. Wow. Well, that's the end of today's video, everybody. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll be back next time with another video.